much cattiness within the kingdom. Mm. I ain't talking about the world. Just God, he's not looking at the world. He's looking at us.
Yeah.
And so, as a woman who loves women, I absolutely love empowering women. I come from a family of women who were very strong women. My grandmother, God rest her soul, was a mother of nine, had a second grade education and couldn't read or write. And so when I think about everything that my grandmother went through to get to where she was, to successfully raise all of her children, to buy a house, you know, you kind of respect the struggle, you know, and I say that because a lot of times we forget where it is that we come from and how will we ever know where we're going if we don't know where we come from.
Exactly.
And so I try to represent not just my grandmother, but my mother and all women because we have such a hard time. Mm-hmm. And we give each other such a hard time.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so today's conference was really, I asked the Lord, what could I do to put a dent into the world, into this big old humongous world, and leave an impact? And I wanted to know, what could I do as far as my sisters? And so one of the things that I came to realize was, as women, we take care of so many people, we tend to neglect ourselves. Whether it's our children, whether it's our careers, our spouses, family members, our girlfriends, we neglect ourselves, and everything begins with us. Everything begins with us. Life begins with us because God used us to give life. And so I think President Obama said it best at his State of the Union when he said, women in America, if America didn't have us women, it probably wouldn't function because we're so powerful. And this conference is really to self-evaluate, to reflect, to be revived, to be rejuvenated, to repent. You know, it's just for self. You know how you be in church and the pastor say, tell your neighbor? Well, we ain't telling no neighbors today. Today it starts with us.
Amen.
So for our first facilitator, whom I truly love, oh my goodness. Some know her as Evangelist Adrienne Hall. Some know her as Mom. Some know her as Queenie. But I know her as a mighty woman of God with substance. When I moved to Baltimore 11 years ago, and joined the church that she's a member of, it was hard to leave familiar to come to unfamiliar, not knowing anybody. But from day one, she's always showed me love. She showed my son and my husband love. She even has a nickname for my husband. I used to know that no other woman had a nickname for my husband. But she called him Burns. That's her husband. And actually, it's a blessing because that's what her mom used to call my husband when he would sneak her cheesesteaks to the restaurant. So she is just a powerful, awesome woman of God. She will be teaching Learning to Love You. I believe that class was important because we can't effectively love other people unless we learn to love ourselves. And so Evangelist Adrienne M. Hall is a member of Gospel Tabernacle Baptist Church, where Bishop Reginald L. Kennedy is the senior pastor. Bishop Kennedy licensed Evangelist Hall on April 18, 2004. She is a community advocate, mentor, mother of twin girls, grandmother of five, and is known to intercede and pray until God answers. Evangelist Adrienne M. Hall earned her master's degree in leadership and management from the True Churches Bible College in 2012. And Evangelist Adrienne Hall graduated as the class valedictorian. Oh my goodness. As a writer, a preacher, a teacher. Right. One of her favorite mottos is, I am a student studying the Bible for life. Mm-hmm. I present to some and introduce to others, Evangelist Adrienne Hall.
Praise the Lord. We come together today to focus on one thing. We're focusing on our